YouTube, what's up? It's your buddy Thanksman. Just bringing you a quick overview today. It's not a review because we all know what this is, or maybe some of you don't. Today I was in the Mart of Wally and strolling through, and around Christmas time I had seen this at on an end cap inside Walmart. So today I was strolling through and saw them again, so I figured I'd pick one up. So it came in a clamshell. I haven't really opened. I just took it out of the package, closed the cap, so I don't know what to expect yet. So we'll examine together. Okay, it's nice tin. I mean, as far as tins go, raised lettering, which is pretty nice. All the pictures of the Buck family. Okay, so it came with a lapel pin, and it says Buck on it as well. That's pretty sweet. Now let's get down to the goodness. Okay, when I was a kid, I had many knives, but I never had the Buck knife. I always had probably every imitation flea market knife out there. But today I picked one up, so the pins of brass. Looks like silver there. I don't know if that's normal. Yeah. Nice brass bolsters. The wood looks pretty good. There is some oil on it from in the packaging. Blade says Buck 110 USA. Very sharp. I believe they make these in 440 stainless steel, to be honest with you. That looks pretty nice. Now the top, wood looks a little different. One looks very dark and the other one looks brown. I think it's just a wood material. No big deal. I plan on using the blade. Brass. Chrome or stainless, same as the other side. But on this side I notice a little bit of discoloration on both the brass bolsters. On the top and the back. That might be from the packaging. The packaging comes like a felt, but inside down with a knife set, it's a plastic material. Really no complaints. I plan on using this blade. Lockup sounds nice. We know there's no play in that. Close is alright. Alright means not, doesn't seem to have that real snap to it as I've seen some have. No complaints though. Like I said, I'm going to use it. So, yeah, I think it was. I like it. It's supposed to have come with a sheath too, and I didn't see the sheath anywhere else but in here. Sheath reads Buck on the front, Buck on the button, and it is a nylon sheath, but it's thick, it's padded. This is almost like a neoprene inside, as to not mar up the blade itself. Can be worn vertical or horizontal. Not sure how I'll carry it, but I will let you know. Yeah, I mean, you can't beat that. Little warranty card. Buck Knives unconditionally warrants that it will repair or, at their option, replace the product if it found contained defects in material or workmanship. Warranty covers replacement parts and labor. The warranty does not cover misuse or abuse. As with most blades, misuse and abuse is under their discretion, I'm sure. So it gives you a little... Oh, silica gel. Throw away, do not eat. Sure, you could probably smoke it. No, don't smoke it. I'm kidding. Don't smoke it. So, in the end, first impressions, very nice. Very nice. For the price point, well, on the end cap, it read $34.88 for this wonderful USA-made blade. 100% USA-made blade. Though the sheath probably is not, does not say. So I figured I'd buy it at $34.88. Then I found out when I got to the register that it was actually on clearance sale for $17. So $17, you can't beat this for $17. I don't care. All right, guys, everybody, you know, I hope everybody enjoyed the mild review of this blade, and I hope everybody is having a good week so far. Everybody, please rate, comment, subscribe, and as always, and most important, be safe. Thank you very much. Later, all.